My first trip to the Soviet Union, there were an enormous number of things have happened, all of which are completely unforgettable to me. But two of the major ones had to do with meeting a fellow named Alexander Grodsky, who is known as Sasha to over 100 million people. He's the most popular singer-songwriter in the Soviet Union. And along with that meeting, there was an experience at a cemetery in Leningrad known as the Piskaryovskaya Memorial Cemetery, in which there are buried over 400,000 people of the more than 600,000 who died in that city alone in the Thousand-Day Siege of Leningrad in the Second World War. In any case, I wrote a song out of that experience and relating it to things going on in our country in the present time, and then had the opportunity to go back to the Soviet Union and, with Sasha's help, get into recording studios in Moscow and to record the vocals for this song with him, and also to include the men's voices from the Red Army Chorus in Moscow. And I think that this is simply the best piece of work that I've done in my career. The song is called "What Are We Making Weapons For?" Let us begin.
From the falls of Minamara to the tops of Bulleye, we're here for you.
Yillawarra's 106.9, Vox FM.
Riding on the tapestry of all there is to see, so many ways, oh, so many things. Rejoicing in the differences, there's no one just like me. Yet as different as we are, we're still the same. And oh, I love the life within me. I feel part of everything I see.
Well, I think more than anything is using my music and the celebrity that I've attained to bring people all over the planet a little bit closer together to understanding that we really are a human family more than anything else. I am pretty much disgusted by the political process in our country, especially where it has to do with campaign spending and the kind of money that goes into that. And I really don't want to be a part of supporting that. You know, the people who do concerts like myself, we're the ones who can raise the big money now. Within the process of that, that seemed like a great waste, not only of time and energy and economic power, if you will, but
a waste in regard to my own feelings about what I try to represent, what I want to do with my life, the thing that I said before.
Yeah.
And I think politics is one of those things that furthers separation among people as opposed to bringing people closer together.
With nuclear warheads and lasers in heaven, fear does the choosing between right and wrong. The arms king sits on his arrogant throne, way and above and apart. Bankers assure him he needn't care. Greed makes a stone of what once was a heart. Raven's child is washing the water. All of her wing feathers blackened with tar. William Shoreline, an unwanted highway, a path fall in anger, an elegant scar. The oil moon sits on his arrogant throne, away and above and apart. Lawyers have warned him, he mustn't speak. Greed has made silent what once was a heart. There are walls that come tumbling down for people who yearn to be free. Still there are hearts that long to be open and eyes that are longing to see. Raven's child is a constant companion, sticks like a shadow to all that is done. Try as we may, we just can't escape him, the source of our sorrow and shame. We are one. The true king sits on a heavenly throne, never away, nor above, nor apart. With wisdom and mercy, constant compassion, he lives in the love that lives in our hearts.
I was telling John in the green room that when I was in Baltimore, had just moved, I was 22 years old, and it was during the 70s, you know, and everybody was Black Power and this and that. And so some friends had come to meet me just to check this new girl out, and they said, all right, so who's your favorite singer? And I said, John Denver. And they said, John Denver. They're expecting the Four Tops or something. Yeah. So they said, don't worry about this girl, this is Miss Goody Two Shoes, just because I listened to John Denver, and John Denver was my favorite.
Well, I appreciate that. I think that's kind of going out on a limb for you to do that.